Now next topic is effective load on bevel gear tooth, P effective. So effective load is nothing but the maximum tangential load acting on the bevel gear tooth at large end. Okay, so load acting on the bevel gear tooth is nothing but a P effective, effective load. And SB and SW are nothing but the strength of the gear tooth. Okay, strength and load are different. Strength is nothing but the strength of the means capacity of the bevel gear. And it is the load acting on the bevel gear. Okay, so external load is acting on the bevel gear, so it is nothing but the P effective. Yeah, so maximum tangential load acting on the gear tooth at large end. Okay, so there are two methods of estimation of this P effective. So methods of estimation of effective load. Okay, so first method is preliminary estimation. Preliminary estimation by velocity factor accounts. Okay, so preliminary estimation by velocity factor accounts. According to this preliminary estimation, P effective PEFF is given by CS, CM, PT divided by CV. CS is nothing but application factor or service factor. CA, CS are same. Okay, so CS, CM, PT divided by CV. Now here CS is application factor, CM is load distribution factor, PT is the tangential force, and CV is nothing but a velocity factor. Now velocity factor is depend on velocity. Now PT you can find, tangential force you can find from power by pitch line velocity, and CV velocity factor for different manufacturing methods are here. CV is equal to 6 divided by 6 plus V for straight bevel gear manufactured by cutting. Okay, so here if the gear is manufactured by cutting process, so you can use this formula, manufactured by cutting. Then CV is equal to 5.6 divided by 5.6 plus under root V for gear, for bevel gear manufactured by generation. Okay, so here manufactured by generation. Okay, then another CV is equal to under root 5.6 divided by 5.6 plus under root V for straight bevel gear finished by grinding or lapping. Okay, so finished by grinding or lapping process. So these are the three different formulas for CV. So according to the manufacturing method, you have to select the formula of velocity factor CV. Okay, PT you can find from this power by velocity, or if suppose you are having torque, so you can write here 2 times torque divided by diameter. If suppose you are having, if you are finding specific, so 2 times torque on pinion divided by DP. Or you can consider gear also, 2 times torque on gear divided by DG. Okay, so torque and diameter, with this you can find PT. Then pitch line velocity. Velocity is nothing but pitch line velocity, and it is given by pi dp np divided by 16 into 1000, or pi dn divided by 16 into 1000, or you can write here pi dp np divided by 16 into 1000, or pi dg ng divided by 16 to 1000, where dp dp and dg are nothing but the pitch circle diameters of pinion and gear, np and g are nothing but the speed of pinion and gear in rpm. Okay, then second method